Definition of democracy means good governance and not merely consensus or compromises. Most laws get attacked because of knee-jerk reaction of people or short-sightedness. So remember not to look for security in a static democracy. Democracy cannot be static. It has to constantly evolve. डेमोक्रेसी हैज टू बी डायनेमिक. और अगर मैं हिंदी में बोलूं तो लोकतंत्र की मेरी परिभाषा का अर्थ है सुशासन और एक अच्छा शासन और ना केवल आम सहमति या समझौता हर समय. अधिकांश कानूनों पर अदूरदर्शिता यानी शॉर्ट साइटेडनेस के कारण चैलेंज किया जाता है या हमला किया जाता है उसके ऊपर. लोकतंत्र को गतिशील होना होगा अगर आपको डेवलपमेंट चाहिए, गुड गवर्नेंस चाहिए. और उसके लिए सत्ता में जो बैठी सरकार है या एक मैनेजमेंट है किसी कंपनी की, को कुछ कड़वे फैसले लेने होंगे इन द लार्जर इंटरेस्ट ऑफ गुड गवर्नेंस. उदाहरण के लिए न्यायपालिका यानी जुडिशरी में क्या होता है, जब आपको न्याय करना हो तो आप सभी को खुश नहीं कर सकते. जब आपको जस्टिस करना होता है, एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ जस्टिस करना होता है. एज ए स्टूडेंट ऑफ पब्लिक पॉलिसी, इफ यू विश टू अंडरस्टैंड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ डेमोक्रेसी, व्हाट डू यू नॉर्मली डू? यू विल नेचुरली पिक अप सम कमेंट्रीज ऑफ यू नो ग्रेट पॉलिटिकल साइंटिस्ट्स, सम एक्सपर्ट्स, intellectuals, academicians, authors, and more. And believe me that you will not find one uniformly accepted definition or description of democracy, or for that matter, any codified or statutory definition. Even if you, let's say, pick up definitions by some great jurists or thought leaders, You will not find any consistency in any of their statements. Kofi Annan, the seventh Secretary General of the United Nations, had once said that there are many different forms of democracy. You know, based on his experience as a Secretary General, he said that there are many forms of democracy. In fact, one research study had identified that there were more than 2,000 adjectives used to describe democracy in the English language. More than 2,000 adjectives used to define democracy. The simplest explanation, I would say, of democracy can be found in ordinary dictionaries like Oxford, Britannica, Webster, and even Wikipedia. So all these dictionaries or encyclopedias define democracy more or less as a system in which the government of a country is elected by the people. Hindi mein bolu to ek aisi vyavastha jisme kisi bhi desh ki sarkar ka nirnayan ya chayan kahein janta dwara kiya jata hai, to use hum loktantra bole ya jantantra bole. Or going a step further, or let me say in other words, democracy would also mean the right of everyone in an organization, etc., to be treated equally and to vote on matters that affect them. So, you know, participation in the decision making process, either directly or indirectly. Or Hindi mein agar isko bolu to संगठन के समस्त सदस्यों को प्राप्त समानता का और स्वयं से संबंधित मामलों पर मत व्यक्त करने का अधिकार. अगर इसको ये हिंदी का अनुवाद क्लोजेस्ट टू व्हाट आई सेड इन इंग्लिश. सो मोस्ट ऑफ अस वुड नो दैट द एक्सप्रेशन डेमोक्रेसी यू नो गॉट फर्स्ट इवॉल्व्ड इन द एंशिएंट ग्रीक पॉलिटिकल एंड फिलोसॉफिकल थॉट्स in the city state of Athens, when the first type of democracy was established there, you know, in Greece, in 508-507 BC. So what we gather is that democracy was conceptualized first more than 2,500 years ago. It's not a new concept. So it has actually gone through massive transformation and change in its meaning, nature, scope, significance, and characteristics since then, you know, especially during the 10th to 17th centuries. And then even in the recent times, you know, 20th and 21st centuries, I mean, we saw aggressive, progressive, and moderate wave of democracy. So in my understanding, democracy of total consensus, compromises, and unanimity is not good for the nation, because it retards development, it retards progress. We all can never be on the same page. Not all can ever think alike and speak in one voice. It's next to impossible. So a healthy democracy means good governance of an organization and nation. And this can be gauged not by unity and agreements of the stakeholders or the electorate all the time. You know, I mean, you can't just boast about consensus, agreements, unity, harmony. My democracy signifies development, the well-being of its workers or people, good infrastructure, ample opportunities, productivity, and so on. So a government, for instance, may bring about a law, I'm repeating again, which may not get full support from all the stakeholders. But if it has an element of farsightedness, then that law should be considered as good and democratic. So these are, according to me, the most vital and essential and imperative elements of democracy in today's time. Democracy has evolved, and let's accept it. So democracy means taking some, let's say, bitter decisions in the larger interest, which means decisions for good governance.